Council for allowing me this opportunity to present these awards here this evening, as well as thanking you for all being here for this award recipients. Nice showing here tonight. Wish we had some more chairs. Tonight, we honor those who earned awards during the 2016 calendar year. The process is provide, the purpose of the award program is provide a method to recognize exceptional effort, heroism, and other highly commendable actions by members of the police department and the community. The process here is nominations are taken throughout the year. The committee is comprised of four members of the police department, myself, my captain Jess Ronick, the most senior sergeant, right now it's Sergeant Doug Hugh Baker, most senior patrolman Mike Kuchenreier, and we have councilman, safety committee Louis Farbach, and we have the city minister Robert Anderson on the committee. Nominations were carefully reviewed and majority vote, but the committee is required to approve each of these nominations here this evening. Award classifications. There's three classifications here. There's Class A award where they get a certificate and a commendation bar. The Class B award is just a certificate that's a pat on the back that we thank you for what you did and we didn't forget about it. And Officer of the Year and Civilian Employee of the Year. Those are our awards. And a pamphlet that you might have in front of you on the left-hand side is all the categories as well as the criteria for those awards. On the right-hand side is going to be those personnel tonight receiving awards. With that said, could I have Patrolman Nathan Eichhorst come forward? Patrolman Eichhorst began his duties as an Northern Police Officer on May 28, 2013. Prior to this, he was an auxiliary police officer for Lake Township. He's also a part-time officer with Rossford and an elected councilman for the village of Walbridge. Nathan consistently displays an attitude, demeanor, knowledge, and character desired for a Norfolk police officer. He values our mission statement and strives to succeed by his guidance on a daily basis. His knack for finding and stopping suspended drivers was impressive. He was able to arrest 71 such violators and he reigns top of the list of officers for self-initiated activity. He conducted over 620 traffic stops and answered and assisted on 1,561 calls for service. He also helps with a regular basis enforcing our commercial vehicle laws, specifically overweight trucks. Captain Rodden says, there's no fear of a task once assigned to him, it's always completed expeditiously. Nathan helped organize two community relations events last year, Coffee with Cops and Cider with Cops, that the community had an opportunity to meet and interact with Norfolk police officers. A few notable cases that we've worked in 2016 include the missing juvenile who was found on Woodmore Street. This has led to multiple charges against the resident for drug trafficking and sex crimes. A drug case where felony charges were issued against the motel guest, an illegal immigrant who was found on a traffic stop and handled by federal agents, and a felony assault case at the 1905 Tracy Road. Lastly, Nathan also pushed himself to excel on a personal level. He recently graduated last week from University of Toledo with a bachelor's degree in criminal justice. And his communication skills he acquired in his leadership role as a councilman is evident in his police work. However, you might mention or notice he's not in his uniform here this evening. Unfortunately, he went to the city of Oregon. They offered him a better opportunity than the city of Oregon. We wish him the best with the city of Oregon, or the city of Oregon. And congratulations.
Thank you.
Is Dispatch Supervisor Amy Scribney. She can come forward. Dispatch Supervisor Scribney began her duties as a Northern Dispatcher on November 3rd, 2003. Then she was promoted on August 24th, 2007 to her current position as Dispatch Supervisor. She's the 2004, 2005, 2006, and now the 2016 Civilian Employee of the Year. Supervisor Strickney oversees the full-time, four full-time dispatchers and two part-time. The communication center is operational 24/7 every day of the year. She's also required to oversee all the aspects of the communication center, as well as perform her own duties. Being open 24/7 creates hurdles that Amy jumps over on a daily basis. She provided a basic schedule that her employees must, and she's got to modify it to ensure proper coverage exists. And employees needing days off or vacation or other forms of leave leads to chaos, but Andy pulls them through by checking with the dispatchers to see what they would work best. However, she could just as well schedule the dispatcher to work what she desired, but she goes out of her way to make sure the dispatchers are happy. Anything that goes on the dispatch center, she has a hand in. The city finished renovations of the communication center in 2016. Amy was here with a paintbrush in hand to help out with the finishing touches. She played an important role in design and ordering materials for a workspace. She's constantly on the phone with repair companies when issues arise on the radio system, phone system, or those new computers we ordered that don't seem to work right all the time. Other responsibilities include overseeing training for new dispatch hires, the record management, keeping police department records in order and disposing of them per our record retention schedule, and those critical ballots from Leeds North every 3 years. While performing these supervisor duties, she's often interrupted. She can account for that. The dispatch police and fire crews emergency calls. However, once the call's over, she picks up right where she left off. Captain Robbins stated she's a crucial part of our daily operations here at the city, and should be recognized for her unending, unselfish tasks that she regularly performs, and despite all these obstacles that she encounters on a daily basis, she's always seen with a smile on her face and got a pleasant head. Congratulations, Amy. Trouble with Nicole Ronstadt, she can come forward. It's a Meritorious Service Award. Coming to Paul Ronstadt has been given several different assignments throughout her 11 and a half years in Columbus Northern Police Department. She is serving as a crash investigator, bike patrol officer, field training officer, lock watch coordinator, part-time dispatcher, and member of the Wood County Honor Guard. Nicole has become an icon within the department, working with the members of the community in the block watch program, which meets the third Wednesday of each month. She represents the department proudly within the Honor Guard unit that performs many functions throughout our region, including the Owens College graduations, plus the Toledo and Wood County Police Memorial Services. Over these 11 and a half years and diverse assignments, Nicole has gotten high praise from the police department and members of the community, as well deserving this award. Congratulations. If I could have Josh Hannum come forward, along with Mr. Thomas Irving, he's here. It's a life-saving award. On August 11, 2016, at 5:41 p.m., Patrolman Josh Hannum, along with EMS personnel, were dispatched to Christian Big Boy for no person. Upon arrival of Officer Hannum and medic, they found Mr. Irving laying unconscious and not breathing on the floor of the restaurant. From him, assisted EMS personnel to the CPR, while EMS personnel did other things to help Mr. Irving. Chief Roslin for the fire department stated the help from Officer Hannum was very much appreciated. Then on August 12, 2016, Barbara Lovell, niece of Mr. Irving, called by office and stated Mr. Irving is still in the cardiac ward at St. D's, complaining of a sore chest with no broken bone. Well, he's grateful to be alive because of the outstanding efforts of Officer Hannum and EMS personnel. Mrs. Lovell further states Officer Hannum performed CPR like a well-oiled machine. And she believes Mr. Irving would have died that day if he'd been any other place in the city of Northwood. Congratulations, John. Exceptional Duty Awards. If I gave it to Jolene Zabel, come forward. The first Safety Town program since the Great Recession in 2008 was held July 25th, 27th, 2016. Jolene began her duties here on July 9th, 2014, and was most instrumental in getting the program back up and running for the city. Her enthusiasm and dedication has led to an outstanding Safety Town presentation being presented to the children that learned several key safety initiatives that will assist them throughout their lives. Congratulations, Julian. Job with the strong. And Kristen Espinosa, come forward. This will be our final award recipient. Kristen June 27, 2016, an elderly woman with a walker came into the communications center with a matter needed to be handled by Norfolk Court on this side of the building. Instead of just pointing across the courtyard to the court office, which could easily have been done, Dispatcher Espinoza making sure the communications had adequate personnel, she walked the lady over to the court, assisted her on her issues with what she had there, and then walked her back up to her car, put her walker back in her trunk. That's outstanding customer service. This is a job well done. Thank you. We have next over here some pictures for our stuff, for Officer of the Year, City Employees, and also employees together. You can have open house at the police department as well as where you guys were at, the snacks, or you can have whatever you want. I thank you.
Thank you.
Get selected.